ever took a photo that you really like overall, but there's something in it that just ruins it? Like, I don't know, a pimple on your forehead, or in this case, a leash in the middle of the dog? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can take a picture like this and turn it into this. So first, make sure that you have your picture open in Procreate. Nothing crazy here. And once that is done, we are going to create a copy of that picture just for safety. So go ahead and open up your layer panel, which is on the two little square icons here on the top. And swipe the layer on which you have your picture towards the left with one finger, so you can have access to this duplicate option here. So just tap on that, and as you can see, now you have two copies. So what I personally like to do is lock one of the copies just to make sure I don't mess with it, and I can always go back to original as needed. So to lock a layer, same thing, just swipe it towards the left with one finger, but then instead of tapping on duplicate, tap on lock. From there, go ahead and select the top copy, so the one that doesn't have the little lock icon. Tap on it, and in the menu, select rename, and rename this one to new picture. So here, I really like my picture of little Waffle, but I find the leash and the color to be really distracting, so I want to go ahead and erase them. Now, if I was to go ahead and color pick all the different colors and try to paint the rocks and match the fur, it would take forever. But there's a really handy tool in Procreate called the Clone tool. And you can access that tool by opening the adjustment panel here at the top, and then selecting Clone at the very bottom. So when you tap on Clone, you're going to see this little circle appear here. And this is essentially what is going to replace your color. So when you're working with the clone tool, the color doesn't matter at all. The brush is going to paint what is inside this little circle here. So let's say I want to hide this part of the leash. I want to hide it with rocks. So I'm going to put my selector circle over some rocks that are very close to the element that I want to hide. And you can use any kind of brush shape with the clone tool, so you get to really experiment. I personally usually just go with from the airbrushing pack that comes with Procreate, so just free brushes, very basic brush. Either the soft brush, if I'm trying to completely erase something and just blend it with the background, or the hard brush if I'm trying to refine an edge. In this case, I don't really have any edge, but let's say, you know, Waffle was not full of hair and she was made of plastic or something, and so it was a really straight edge. To make sure my edge would be really clean between the rocks and the plastic fur, I would go ahead and use the hard brush in that area. But in this case, I just want the leash to essentially disappear, and I want the rocks to kind of blend together, so I'm just going to use the soft brush. You can also adjust the size of the brush. You're going to have to experiment with that depending on your picture. But if I start drawing, you can see that it recreates what is in the circle. So the circle is going to move along with you as you draw. Now, it might take a few tries of positioning the circle in different areas and kind of seeing what works best. But once you find a good spot, you can just go ahead and very quickly just paint over the element that you want to essentially erase. And you can also move the circle as you go to just sample from different areas. Just make sure that you stick with areas that have similar amount of light on them, because you can see here, although these are still rocks, these are in the light, and this part is in the shadow, which means these rocks here that I copied from there just look crazy. So just staying in the same kind of area as the element that you're trying to erase. So let's say here I want to go between the legs, I'm going to put my selector here. And then I'm just going to very precisely go over and erase the leash. Now here I want to repeat the little hair on the side of the leg, because right now it looks super weird. So I'm just going to position the selector right in the middle. So half hair, half rocks. And I'm just going to drag upwards to recreate the edge of the leg. So really the main challenge with this clone tool is figuring out where to put your selector so that both the pattern and the light match. And that can be really quite tricky. And in some areas you can probably go with a really big brush and just do a broad stroke. In some other areas you're probably going to need to be really precise and go in with a smaller brush. And just like that, you can now fix any of your pictures. Now, if you enjoyed this video and want to learn more Procreate tips and tricks, I highly recommend you check out this playlist because I have a bunch more for you. But before you leave, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly videos I post every Tuesday and Saturday. Then click on the link right here, and I'll meet you there.